What's up, family? We're back for another Sunday message. But today is the Resurrection Sunday. It's Easter, y'all. Listen, it's the first time in our lives or in my life that I've never been able to be in the four walls of a church on Easter Sunday. But it doesn't matter because Easter is not in the church four walls does not mean that we're not going to have ministry, does not mean that we're not going to have church. So I urge that you get around with your family, that you spend time with your family today and reflect on what Jesus did for you. Remember, hope is not canceled. Hope is not canceled. And that's literally what we're going to talk about a little bit today. We're going to see a character in the Bible who in the moment, in the process of doubt, he lost hope. He lost a form of hope. All right. So we're going to go to John chapter 20. Go to John chapter 20, and we're going to start at verse 24. John chapter 20, verse 24. It says, "Now Thomas, also known as Didymus, one of the 12, was not with the disciples when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, 'We have seen the Lord.' But he said to them, 'Unless I see the nail marks in his hand and put my finger where the nails were and put my hand into his side, I will not believe.'" Before we get into verse 24, I want to give us context on what's going on. Jesus has been crucified and he's been resurrected. He has shown himself to Mary, and Mary has told the disciples that Jesus is alive, and that all the disciples came together and they were in a locked room. But they were in a locked room because they were in fear that the same people that crucified Jesus would try to come after them. But Jesus appears to them. The Bible says that Jesus appeared to them in verse 19 on that evening, and he told them, "Peace be with you." And in that moment, the disciples were overjoyed. Now that we have context, it leads us back to verse 24. The Bible says that Thomas was not there when the disciples saw Jesus. And it also says that when the disciples finally saw Thomas and told him that they saw the Lord, Thomas did not believe. And he started saying that he needed to see the nails. He needed to put his hand inside. If he didn't, he would not believe. And let that be our first point. Godly community matters. See, in this moment, Thomas isolated himself. He wasn't there when Jesus appeared to the rest of the disciples. So when he heard that Jesus was alive, it was hard for him to believe. And in the same way, when you isolate yourself and people begin to try to tell you the truth, it's hard for you to believe it, because isolation can cause you to lose hope. Isolation can cause you to make you think that everything is not going to be okay. And see, in this time right now, COVID-19, Corona, or just life, everything that we know is different. And the biggest thing that we can do is lean on our godly community. The biggest thing that we can do is believe what Jesus said. The biggest thing we can do is pray to our Father who is in heaven, that loves us, that said he would never leave us nor forsake us. So make sure that you're leaning on your godly community in this time. And after we understand that godly community matters, our next point is that Jesus knows exactly what we need. Write that down. Jesus knows exactly what we need. We find Thomas and the rest of the disciples a week later. Now they're all in the same house and they have the doors locked, and Jesus appears, and the first thing he says is, "Peace be with you." And then after he says, "Peace be with you," he goes directly to Thomas, the same Thomas that just doubted and said, "I need to touch, I won't believe until I'm able to touch and see him for myself." So he goes directly to Thomas and he tells Thomas, he says, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe." In the same way, Jesus wants you to believe him. He knows exactly what you need, but you got to be open. You have to be willing to let him in. And this is what's so beautiful about it. He went directly to Thomas. He didn't address any other disciples in this moment. He went directly to Thomas because he knows that Thomas is struggling in this moment. And in the same way, God knows you may be struggling at home right now. God knows that you may be struggling trying to figure out, hey, what's next? God knows you may be struggling to even maybe believe in him right now. But let me tell you about the power of the resurrection. When Jesus was raised from the dead, he had all power in his hands. So he has the power to help you to understand and help you to believe that he can sustain you and that He knows exactly what you need. Not only will He give you what you need, He also conquers unbelief. He ends the text with Thomas at verse 28 and 29. He says, Thomas believes in that moment and he says, you believe because you see me, but blessed are the ones who believe and yet to see me. Listen, let me tell you, I know sometimes it's hard to trust and believe in things we can't see. I know it's hard to not know when this COVID-19 is going to be over. I know it's hard to not know when you're going to be able to leave your house. I know it's hard to not lose hope with everything that's going on, with every nuance that's happening around us that we can't control. But let me tell you something. You can give it to Jesus. He has the power to resurrect. He has the power to quench your unbelief. All you got to do is be a willing vessel. He says, be open. He's not going to enter in a room that you won't let him. So open up your heart today. Open up your mind and let Jesus come in and kill your unbelief. Let him take it away from you. Let him take it away from you. Because right now we're in a time where it's so much uncertainty. But if you lean on Jesus, he had the power to resurrect. He has the power to take your unbelief. Just trust in him. Know that he knows exactly what you need. And that's all I got to say to y'all, man. I love you. And let us pray. Father God, we thank you. We honor you. We adore you. Thank you for sending your son to die on the cross and resurrect for us. And right now, my prayer is that if there's anybody that's watching this video that does not know you for themselves, that does not know you as the resurrected Savior, Lord God, I pray that you allow them to come into their, that they will allow you to come into their life right now. Lord God, it's a crazy season, it's a crazy time, and we don't really know what to do, but we do know that you know exactly what we need. We do know that you give us biblical and godly communities, and we also know that you can conquer our unbelief. So we thank you right now in advance. In Jesus' mighty holy name we pray, amen. Love y'all, man. Happy Resurrection Day. I hope you are able to get out there and get some Easter egg hunts or whatever else your family will do. Just enjoy your family today. We love you. We miss you. I'll see y'all soon.